YouTube, what's going on, baby? Booyah Nation, we did it. Welcome back to the Road for Champions RTG edition. More like the Rich Man, the Glory edition. More like the 30-0 edition. We did it, bros. 30-0. Oh, man, it's just unbelievable. Bros, if you think it's absolutely amazing that we did it, can you smash that thumbs up? Can we get 20,000 likes? You know I don't ask for a lot of likes like that. But this is such an awesome accomplishment. 17-0 at this point, 13 games to go as we are about to jump back into the weekend league. We got so much to talk about. I played one of the better NA pros. We'll talk about it all. Yes, I'm using this team. Yes, it's a Rich Man of Glory. Yes, it's a crazy looking team. But realistically, bros, crazy team or not a crazy team, it's unbelievable to go 30-0. And I can't believe, does this 30-0 feel better than the 40-0, I'll get to that in 1 second. This right here is actually against a viewer, and I want to bring this up, bros, because no negativity towards this viewer, no negativity towards this person, but I want to show you how fast something gets taken out of proportion, and I get put on a website, and they make me look like a bad guy and say, like, skills are such a this, skills are such a that, and it becomes bad. I get into this game right here, and I'm winning this game 1-0, and I come right back down the field in this game, and I'm going to make it 2-0 in this game, okay? Now, my opponent is going to get back into this game, and I'm going to tell you what happens. So, I have 17 shots on target, or 17 shots in the game. My opponent has one shot, and he scores. So, up until the 82nd minute, I am going to attack my opponent. In the 84th minute, when I get the ball back, I'm not going to give the ball back to my opponent. I don't pass it around the back. I pass it around my midfield. My opponent went on Twitter. He's one of my viewers. He's like, Skills, man, you out-teamed me. There was no need for you to pass the ball around the back. I passed around the ball around the back the last 5 minutes of the game. And more of the midfield, not the back. Why did I do it? I attacked my opponent the entire game. 17 shots, bro. 17 shots. 9 on target. He shot once and scored. And I couldn't score. For me to keep attacking my opponent, I was putting myself at a disadvantage because he could have countered me, scored on me. We went to extra time, and he could have beat me. And this is the difference between winning a lot of games in FIFA and not winning a lot of games. Now, somebody might turn right there, and everybody on Twitter was like, no way, Skills play that. Skills don't play like that. Skills don't play like that. And I didn't play like that. The way he was tweeting it, it almost made it seem like I held the ball in the back the entire game. And that's just not the case at all. Like, I literally held it for the last 6 minutes after I had taken 17 shots. I attacked so much and I couldn't score that when I got to the last 6 minutes, I said, look, top 100, I won it. I have two choices here. I can keep attacking him and know I'm not going to score because I already shot 17 times and I couldn't score. And I can risk getting countered, or I can hold the ball and make sure my opponent doesn't score. So I decided I'm going to hold the ball and make sure my opponent doesn't score because obviously offensively I can't score. And literally his tweet with me was like, Skills, you know, you out-teamed me. You really need to work on your finishing. It's not cool to hold the ball in the back. Bro, I didn't hold the ball in the back. I did for the last 6 minutes. It wasn't even the back. It was in the midfield. I held the ball in the midfield. And I that was the games that FIFA's against you, bro. That's the games that FIFA, like, no matter what you do, it feels like it's not going to go in. So I did what I felt I had to do. And if I had to go back into that situation and redo it, I would have done it the same exact way. I would have attacked for the entire game. And the last 6 minutes of the game, I would have clutched it out because that's what I do in all of my games. Because whether I score 4 goals, 5 goals, or beat you by 1 goal, I'm getting the same skill rating. At the end of the day, I got to pick up the W because, like, every win is so important trying to get top 100. More importantly, like, I don't want to make it seem like a negative thing. I'm trying to, like, show how crazy one comment can turn into, oh, man, Skills is a bad guy. Skills does this because everyone, like, a lot of people are tweeting him back, like, yo, like, really, Skills plays like that? Like, no way, for real. Like, it turned into that all of a sudden without me even getting my point across. Like, would y'all say I did something bad by doing that? Or that I did something that had to be done? Right here, I am playing against Apollo. Apollo is one of the best players in the NA's brother. Goal machine. Played in the event last year, went hella far last year over in, like, Germany or Berlin or what, Berlin or England, wherever it was. He went hella far. I play his brother, and, like, 3 games later, I'm going to play Goal Machine. I'm going to be 100% honest with you. I don't think I've ever beaten Goal Machine. I think maybe one time. I've beaten almost every single NA pro, and they've beaten me, and I've beaten them, and we've given each other good games. I don't think I've ever beaten Gold Machine. I swear to you guys. But this weekend, everything changed. And I don't even know how. Honestly, bro, like, it's just one of those things that, like, things kind of went our way, man. And that's what you need. Like, that's the difference. But again, I want to go back to that game where I played with the ball in the middle of the pitch. And the reason I want to go back to that game is because if you're playing FIFA, whether you're playing for top 100, gold one, elite one, whatever you're playing for, bros, you really need to make sure you manage games. And I did that right there to manage the game. And sometimes you need to do stuff like that because I don't care how good of a player you are. I don't care if you're the best player in the world, the worst player in the world, a top 100 player, an elite player. There's going to be games where you struggle to score. And in those games, you really, really, really got to clutch it out. You got to find a way to clutch it out. You got to do what you got to do to get the dub. Imagine if I attacked him for the last 6 minutes. I shoot, I hit the post, he counters me, he scores, I go to extra time, I lose. Our 30-0 is over. Simply because I attacked an opponent that had one shot the entire game. I had 17 shots the entire game. And simply because I attacked, I put myself at a disadvantage. Again, no negativity towards my viewer, like the guy who tweeted me, bro, I love you to death, bro. Like, thank you so much for watching my channel. It means the world to me. I'm just trying to, like, explain to how quick someone's comment can turn into something really bad about me when I literally didn't even have my a chance to defend myself yet. And now that I put my point across, I think most people would have done what I did. With that being said, we go to penalties, bro. And at this point, bros, I'm not even thinking, like, I'm 10 games away from being 30-0. I'm not even thinking 30-0 at this point, bros. I'm literally thinking elite one, let me try to get top 100 for the Booyah Nation. Like, this is the biggest thing, because I know what's going to come from this video. All right, first of all, let's talk about this. What feels better, the 30-0 or the 40-0? In FIFA 17, I accomplished 40-0, and that feeling, they both feel great, but the 40-0 was a little bit more, because although I didn't go to FIWC, which is the Interactive World Cup, the big tournament, although I didn't go to it, I qualified for that tournament by going 40-0. So I was one game out or two, no, I was two games out of Interactive World Cup, and I had to go 40-0 to get Interactive World Cup, and I went 40-0. And that was such a huge accomplishment. And I actually didn't go to FIWC because I had bronchitis and I couldn't go. I don't know if I would have gone either way, but regardless, that was that situation. And I always tell you guys how I don't really do this to be a pro, and I really don't do this to be a pro. Matter of fact, the entire time that I had 30-0, when I get there, and we'll talk about it in a minute, I kept saying, this is going to be such a lit video. This is going to be such a lit video. The Booyah Nation is going to go crazy, because that's what it's about to me. It's not about pro events. It's not about making a pro team. To me, it's about, yo, this video is going to be lit. This video is going to be fire. These rewards are going to be sick. Like, that's what it's all about for me, bro. I'm a YouTuber at heart, bro. I'm a YouTuber. I make content, and it's what I love to do. I'm just so happy that I got 30-0 for you guys. I'm literally so happy that we get the 14th in the world rewards. Like, that is sick. 14th or 13th. I don't even know what it is right now, but I want to be honest with you guys, man. This video was not supposed to come out today. So today's video, which you're going to watch tomorrow. Also, right here, I don't know if this is a viewer. I don't know exactly what. I messaged him. I was like, yo, you're a GOAT. I don't know if he was a viewer, if he saw my team and he was like, I don't want to play against this guy. I don't know what it was. But for the first time in FIFA 19, this has happened to me. He literally off a kickoff, sends it to his keeper, scores, and backs out. I don't know if it was a viewer. I don't know what it was. So I have no idea. If it was a viewer, it does kind of suck because I never want to just be handed a win. I want to work for it, bros. You guys know that I'm out here grinding and grinding and grinding to get better. So I don't know if it was a viewer. I have no idea. I have no idea at all. Or if he just saw my team. I end up playing one of the same guys that we played like game two of this episode, and I play him again. But anyways, bros, man, back to the conversation, man. I just always think it, like, this is gonna be so lit. So I didn't have this video planned. What I had for you guys today, and honestly, when I post the video tomorrow, y'all are gonna hear me talking about, because I did squad battle rewards. We got top 100 squad battle rewards. And in that video, I'm talking about, oh, I got 13 games left. I'm going to play the 13 games. And that video was supposed to go today. But then I got 30-0, and I said, oh, no, this video has to go today. And we got to push the squad battle rewards back, because I didn't want y'all to wait. I wanted to tell you guys how sick it is that we got 30-0. I'm just so damn excited that we did it. And I've been preaching this for the past few videos. It doesn't matter that I got this mega team. I know a lot of people, most people are going to be like, oh, skills, You got it because you're the mega team. Let's just all remember that Road to Glory last year, we got top 100 a bunch of times, top 100 monthly with a straight gold team, bro. Like, so I don't know if I would have got 30-0 with a Road to Glory. I don't know what the heck would have happened. That's not the point here. All I'm trying to say is, yes, I have a big team. What I'm trying to tell you guys, and again, people could tell me I got it because of a mega team, bro. I'm going to agree with you. I can't say it in my videos because people are going to say, Skills, if you say this right now that you're trash in a 30-0 video, I'm going to smack you. But realistically, if you say I only got it because of my mega team, I'm with you, brother. Like, whatever. I'm cool. Like, that's not hurting my feelings. It is what it is. I don't care because I don't run around here saying I'm good. I don't even run around here saying I'm going to go to a pro tournament. I'm always saying I'm not going to go to a pro tournament because for me, again, it's not about this. For me, it's about literally trying to get the best content and being able to come back to you guys and tell you something. And what I want to come back and tell you guys about today is the same thing I've been preaching about. Get players that work for you. Get them. Get players that work for you. I've been preaching this. And you'll be like, what do you mean? This is a sick goal I put together here simply because I did a skill move and I never ever do skill moves. What am I saying? Top 100, 28-2 week one. Bang, we did it. What do? We go, oh, snap, I want Rio Ferdinand. Brrr, boom, we get Rio Ferdinand. We go into the next week. We miss top 100, 27-3. We miss top 100. I come into this weekend. I sell Rio Ferdinand, who is an icon that's worth mils. I bring Varane back. The only thing that's the same on my back line from week one to week two is that Varane is back in Maldini. The only thing that changed in week two was that we brought Rio in. I brought Varane back, who is a worse center back than Rio Ferdinand on paper, and we went 30-0. If it ain't broke, don't fix it. If it works for you, keep it. If the player looks trash, but he's amazing, keep it. Whether it's Ronaldo or Walcott or Varane or Umtiti or whoever, Lukaku, it doesn't matter who it is. If he's good for you, don't worry about upgrading him. Because sometimes an upgrade is not an upgrade. It looks like an upgrade, but it's not an upgrade. It sounds like an upgrade, but it's not an upgrade. An upgrade is something that helps you. Rio put us down. And maybe I just played really poorly that weekend. I don't know. But what I do know is that when I got Maldini and when I got Varane, it's lights out. You're seeing that people just aren't really scoring on me a lot. I'm suffering like a goal or two a game. But last weekend, bro, I would score 7 goals and my opponent would score 6. I would score 5 goals, my opponent would score 8. I couldn't win. I had to win shootouts. Here I go up by so much. This guy starts scoring on goals. People were scoring on goals for some reason, man. I was scoring and then they were like scoring on goals. So I don't know what the heck, but I kept scoring. I kept doing my thing. And we're getting really, really close at this point to being a chance at top 100. And at this point, I started to think a little bit like, okay, this is possible because now I have 25 wins and I got 5 games remaining. And for us to get top 100, I literally have to win what is it? 3 of the last 5? And then I get matched up against Goal Machine. This guy is unbelievable, bros. When I tell you guys that this is one of the best players in the NA, I mean, he's top 3, bro. This guy is fire. This guy is such a good player. He's a beast. He almost beats me every time. I'm gonna cheese the hell out of him. I'm gonna get him with a corner goal with Cristiano Ronaldo in the 65th minute, and then I'm gonna win the game. And that's what I mean, bros. I went up against one of the better NA players, and Varane was able to clamp him up. Maldini was able to clamp him up. I stayed in my 4-1-2-1-2 formation. I didn't go to a defensive formation because I knew that if I went defensive, he was gonna beat me straight up. I said, I'm staying 4-1-2-1-2. I'm gonna try to counter him. I know he's gonna put a lot of pressure on me right now. He's gonna go all aggression, all pressure up. He's gonna push everything up on me. I gotta find a way to counter him and score. So that's why I stayed in the 4-1-2-1-2 and I was able to clamp him up, defend him, and not suffer any goals and walk out of there with probably the biggest win of the weekend. No, by far the biggest win of the weekend. And right after I won that game, I told myself, you know what? We might get top 100. That's a bicycle kick there for Mbappe. I still wasn't thinking 30-0. I was just thinking, okay, this is possible. Because there's always going to be a game on your weekend that if you win that one, like in my head, I tell myself, if we get this one, this is the one. If we can win this one, this is the one. We're getting top 100. And when I beat Goal Machine, I was like, we might get this. This might be the one. So an absolute unbelievable win against, like I said, bros, I'm not lying to you. He has to be top 3, man, if not top 2 in the NA. The dude is unbelievable. As you can see, we are playing team after team, brother. Mega team after mega team, brother. This was huge, bro. We got Gold Machine. We got a mega team right after that. We got another mega team after that. And of course, I got a mega team. So it was a big game. I go down behind in this game. And at this point, I'm thinking to myself, yo, the skills, don't choke top 100. Do not choke top 100, because last weekend I choked top 100. Remember, I was like 26, like 24-1. And then I ended up 27-3 or something. So I choked last weekend. I was thinking to myself, like, skills, don't do this again, man. I get back into the game with that. And then I skip into the lead with Cristiano Ronaldo over the top header. Big goal. And again, bros, like, the biggest thing I want to give in this video is, first of all, do something because you enjoy it. That's number one. I do this because I enjoy it. I do the weekend league because I enjoy it. I don't do it for a pro thing. I do it because I enjoy it, and I enjoy making YouTube videos for you guys around this content. Point blank, period. I don't force myself to play it. I literally play it because I enjoy it. I love making the content. I love reading the comments. I love trying to help you guys. I love trying to show you guys the best formations, the best tactics, and what to do. I love that feeling. I love that. I love it so much, man. I don't play this to be a pro. And I keep saying it because I know a lot of people are like, Steelz, you went 30 and you got to play in the pro tour. You have to. I don't really do it for that. But more importantly, do it because you love it. Do it because you're having fun with it, the weekend league. Build a team that the players work for you. And number three, know when it's time to clutch out a game. You know what I'm saying? Know when it's time. And people might be like, ah, you played that last 10 minutes like a little whatever, you know? You played it such a, oh, you're a rat, this and that. Bro, if I go into a game and I have 17 shots and my opponent has one, why the hell am I going to keep attacking if I could only score 2 goals for the last 10 minutes? Like, it just makes no sense. Clamp out the game, clutch it out, get out of there, get the win. Because imagine if I would have lost that game, that would have been so undeserved. So at the end of the day, man, do what you got. And even if you don't have the shots, bro, if you have the lead and there's 5 minutes left and you want to clutch a game out, bro, because it's the weekend league and it's hard to get wins. And honestly, if you're clutching out a win, bro, it's because your opponent's a good player and you're trying to, like, show them almost respect because you're trying to clutch it out, man. Like, I'm not saying don't be a rat. Don't pass back to your goalie. And I don't do that. I pass around the midfield. Like, I put it in a place because I don't even like passing around the back, because if you steal it from my back line, you're going to steal it and be on net. So I pass around in my midfield. Either way, also, another thing I want to tell y'all, these time finesses from outside the box. I mean, I know y'all been watching this video. That's all I score. I literally do time finesses over and over and over and over and over. At this point, bros, we are 29-1 as we get matched up against an awesome team. And I saw the name, it's Ice. And instantly in my head, I remembered this name from like FIFA 17, FIFA 18. I was like, dude, this dude is nice. This dude is a great player, and I'm pretty sure he's one of my viewers as well. I'm almost 100% sure he was one of my viewers. But I score like instantly into the game, and now he's attacking the hell out of me with that hullet, bro. And I'm like, oh man, I'm so scared because I think I'm going to choke the game. And he's like, we're attacking back and forth. Luckily, again, the time finesse from outside the box, I hit with my man Mateus. He keeps attacking me. I get him on the counter right here. I get down, go down the wing. And like I told you, time finesses and crossing, baby, that's where it's at this year for me, man. I send this one to, I don't even know how I don't score here. Mbappe off the crossbar, it's so cheese. But then he turns around, scores the goal, and leaves. I was going in, bro. I was like, oh, I'm gonna score. I wanted it so bad that I probably should have been up 3-0. He ends up scoring the last goal. I freak out at this point. I go mental because we get 13th in the world, 30-0. I was up 2-0. Again, Ice, I'm pretty sure you're a viewer. I'm pretty sure I remember you. Like, I remember names of players that are good. So instantly when I saw your name, I was like, oh, come on, man. Because I thought you were going to smack the hell out of me. I start playing hella hard because I think he's going to smack me. I end up scoring 2 goals. Should have had a third. He ends up scoring and leaving. So unbelievable, man. This weekend was unbelievable. Honestly, I'm just blessed that I was able to do it for you guys. To that viewer that in the beginning of the game, bro, like, please don't take anything to heart, man. Like, honestly, bro, like, the last 6 minutes, I just clutched it out. I love you, bro. I didn't mean to get you mad at me or anything like that. And to everybody else, man, thank you for supporting me and the videos. And I'm just glad I was able to do it for you guys, man, because you viewers, you guys deserve it more than anything, man. Big thumbs up. Make sure to subscribe. I love you.